Are you ready to take your cloud computing skills to the next level? Or maybe you're thinking about AWS certifications as a way to help learn AWS and validate your existing skills. Maybe you're looking to showcase these certification achievements to help you get that dream job working with AWS and cloud technologies. But AWS offers 12 different certifications today. Which one is right for you to start with? Or if you already have one or more AWS certifications now, which one should you do next to align with your learning and career goals? Well, today we're diving into this exciting world of AWS certifications, and by the end, you'll be an expert about what these different certification types are all about and how to confidently decide what certification and overall certification path is right for you. Now, to start us off here, let's take a look at the different certification tracks available. AWS certifications are categorized into four different tracks or categories. We have foundational, associate, professional, and specialty. And each track is designed to cater to specific skill levels and areas of expertise. When deciding on which AWS certification to choose, your existing experience level can help you find the right track you should be looking at. Now, there's no longer any prerequisite certification requirements for any of the AWS certifications. As an example, if you don't have any AWS certifications today, but you have 5 or more years experience directly working with AWS and across various projects, and you want to take one of those professional level certifications first, there's no prerequisites to hold you back. You don't need any of those foundational or associate level certifications first to jump right into the professional or specialty certifications. Now, is jumping straight into a professional or specialty certification a good idea? For most people, even if you do have a ton of on-the-job experience, I would strongly advise against this. Even though you may have the AWS experience and topic knowledge, you won't have the AWS exam experience knowledge. Doing at least one associate level certification first before tackling a professional or specialty level certification will give you a sense of the AWS exam itself, the format of the questions, and even how to budget your time during the exam. If you are thinking of jumping straight into a professional or specialty certification, be sure to spend a lot of time doing practice exams first to just get yourself prepared for the exam experience. So back to these certification tracks, they're a great logical grouping around the different types of AWS certifications. You can use these to filter out any certifications that may be beyond your current experience level today, or you can use them to zone in on certifications that best represent where you want to focus your energy based on your specific career goals and interests. So let's take a closer look at each one of these tracks, and we'll begin with the foundational certification. And this entry-level track is perfect for those that are brand new to AWS. It provides that solid foundation by introducing fundamental concepts and terminology around general cloud computing and AWS. The certification here is called the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner and covers the very important foundational knowledge of cloud computing technologies and, of course, the basics of AWS architecture, the core AWS services, security, compliance, and billing and pricing. Next, we'll move on to the Associate track, which is sort of that next step that builds on that foundational level. Here you'll find 3 certifications, the Solutions Architect, Developer, and SysOps Administrator. These certifications are designed for cloud technology professionals with some hands-on experience working with AWS already, but we'll talk about these experience expectations in a bit. Now, let's start with the Solutions Architect Associate Certification. This one is all about designing secure, resilient, high-performing, and cost-effective solutions on AWS. It covers those architectural best practices, networking, storage, security, and a bunch more. So if you enjoy designing robust and scalable systems, the certification is a great fit for you. And then next up, we have that Developer Associate Certification. Now, this one focuses on building and maintaining applications on the AWS platform. Here you'll learn about the AWS services, debugging, deployment, and best practices for deploying secure and scalable applications. So if you love coding and want to specialize in AWS application development, this is certainly the certification for you. Then last but not least in the associate track here is the SysOps Administrator Associate Certification. SysOps administrators are responsible for deploying, managing, and operating systems on AWS. And this certification covers topics such as provisioning, monitoring, scaling, and troubleshooting. So if you're passionate about system administration and want to specialize in AWS, this is that certification that'll really sharpen your skills in those areas. Then moving up the ladder, we arrive at the professional track. Now, these certifications are aimed at experienced professionals who have a deep understanding of AWS services and a lot of hands-on experience in designing, deploying, and managing applications on the AWS platform. Now, AWS recommends 2 or more years experience actively working with AWS for certifications in this track. Again, we'll discuss this kind of experience expectation a bit shortly. The first certification in this professional track is the Solutions Architect Professional. It focuses on advanced architectural design skills, including modern cloud-native multi-tier applications, designing solutions across large hybrid environments, and solutions for complex workload migration scenarios. So if you're an experienced solutions architect looking to take your skills to the next level, this certification will push you to new heights and validate your skills with AWS. And then next, we have the DevOps Engineer Professional Certification. Now, DevOps engineers play a critical role in automating and streamlining the software delivery process and infrastructure automation. And this certification covers continuous integration and continuous deployment, a lot of infrastructure as code, monitoring, and logging. So if you excel at bridging that gap between development and operations, this certification will solidify your experience there. And finally, let's explore the specialty track. Now, these certifications are designed for professionals with in-depth knowledge in specialized areas of AWS or different technology areas. They allow you to differentiate yourself and showcase your expertise in specific domains. AWS offers various specialty certifications, including advanced networking, security, machine learning, databases, data analytics, and more. And these certifications deep dive into the respective subjects, testing you on specific knowledge and skill sets in these domain areas that are highly sought after in today's job market. So now that we've covered all the different AWS certification tracks, let's talk about creating a personalized certification roadmap for you based on your starting experience, your existing job role, and your different career goals and interests. So if you're new to AWS and looking to kickstart your career in cloud computing, I highly recommend getting started with the foundational certification. The AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner is often skipped over, as you know, a lot of people suggest to jump straight to the associate level certifications. However, depending on your existing experience level, the job role you're in today, and if you've ever taken an AWS certification before, I feel this is a really important certification to strongly consider. Now, I have a full video on the channel here that gets into why you shouldn't overlook the Cloud Practitioner certification. So definitely check it out before making a decision to skip over that foundational track and the Cloud Practitioner certification. If you missed that video, it's likely because you're not subscribed to the channel yet. If you find these videos helpful, be sure to give it a like and consider subscribing so you can stay up to date on more helpful cloud and DevOps topics and different certification training that's coming really soon. Now, the Cloud Practitioner certification really is a great first step for many people, especially if you're new to cloud and AWS or in a non-technical role today working with AWS. So after the Cloud Practitioner, or you already have that foundational knowledge from existing on-the-job experience, you can progress to the associate track. Choosing the certification aligns with your desired role, whether that's a solutions architect, a developer, or the SysOps administrator. My advice here would be to do the solutions architect associate certification first within that associate track. This is often the one that comes up a lot in job description requirements, and has the ideal scope to really introduce you to a broad range of AWS services and solution design areas. Even if you're an application developer or a system administrator, having that core AWS design principle knowledge etched in your brain will be really important in your role and day-to-day work. Now, after the Solutions Architect Associate certification, things get a bit tricky, and it really depends on what your goals are with AWS certifications. The path a lot of people take is to move horizontally within a track first before taking that vertical jump to the professional or specialty tracks. If you really want to have a broad set of AWS skills and you don't mind committing to multiple AWS certifications, doing all those associate level certifications is the recommended approach for a lot of people. The idea here is we keep building on that foundation and making it as strong as we can. The concepts from that foundational level track should be rock solid at this point. And then we layer on the broader and deeper knowledge scopes around the AWS solutions design when developing and operating applications on AWS. Now, if you're solely in a solutions architect type of role, it may make sense for some already experienced people to achieve that solutions architect professional certification rather than horizontally move through the associate certifications. Again, it really depends on what your goals are here. I strongly recommend having all the associate level certifications first as a way to build that strong base. The topics covered in the professional and specialty level tracks have all the topics of the associate levels as, assumed knowledge as you head into these higher level tracks. Another key thing to think about is if you look at the AWS certification exam guide for those different associate level exams, there's quite a bit of topic overlap. So if you start with the Solutions Architect Associate, you'll likely already have, you know, 60 to 70% of the knowledge needed for the developer and SysOps administrator certifications. The other certification exams would just, you know, have a few new areas added, and they go a bit more in depth in a few topics. So by, you know, doing these additional certifications in the associate track, you're not necessarily, you know, tripling your study time and effort by getting all three associate level certifications. Now, my recommendation is that after doing all the AWS associate certifications, you actually jump across into the specialty track a bit. As these AWS certifications have been updated through the years, more and more topic scope and weighting has been focused on security and compliance areas. Remember, AWS is constantly evolving the certification program, and there's been an obvious and critical need to keep AWS infrastructure and, you know, your workloads that run on it very secure. So with that being said, I'd suggest doing the AWS Certified Security Specialty Certification next. Not only will the areas you'll learn about and the domains covered in that exam topic scope be, you know, critical for the real world, you'll have this heightened security knowledge that'll serve you well as you head into the professional level exams. Again, you'll see security topics be a core part of many of the domain areas tested on the professional exams. If we quickly take a look at the Solutions Architect Professional Exam Guide and look at the weighting of the different domains, there's actually zero mention of security here. Now, you're likely thinking, Mike, you just made this huge point about, you know, how critical AWS security and compliance topics are, especially for these professional level certifications, but it doesn't look like security even comes up in these domains at all. Well, let's actually dive a bit deeper here. So each of these domains are breaking up into these different task statements, and these would be typical task areas to achieve the given domain objective listed. So taking this first domain as an example, design solutions for organizational complexity. As a professional level AWS solutions architect, you're often faced with these very complex, multifaceted environments and workloads within an organization. So as an SA, you'll need to design solutions for these complex environments. Some of these solution tasks AWS identified here are architect network connectivity strategies, prescribing security controls, designing reliable and resilient architectures, and so on. So in this first domain, we have a very specific callout for the ability to provide security controls. And then to do this effectively, we should have knowledge in the areas like IAM, the IAM Identity Center and other single sign-on solutions, then route tables, security groups, and the list goes on. Then you would use these knowledge areas together to form the skills needed to evaluate these cross-account access management solutions, design integrations with third-party identity providers, perhaps with Okta, Azure AD, or Google Workspaces. So to be able to answer the complex professional level exam question scenarios around prescribing security controls when designing solutions for these large organizations with a lot of complexity, we need to have that broad and deep understanding of the AWS security design principles, general best practices, and knowledge of the, you know, nuanced security details specific to different AWS services. Now, again, we've just been looking at the very first domain here. If we look at the second one, we see a similar theme. Domain 2 focuses on designs for new solutions. And here we have a specific task statement calling out a number of security and compliance-related knowledge and skill areas. And the same thing with Domain 3, and again with Domain 4. So thanks for sticking with me here on all this security stuff, but I really wanted to spend a few minutes to go through all this for your awareness and just help inform you so you can take the right certification path for you. The AWS certification exams have had this continuous push and increased exam weighting towards these security and compliance areas over the years. And then the expectation at the professional track is that these security aspects are basically baked in into all your design and implementation decisions you make at this professional level. So a bit of a tangent there, but I hope that really explains my strong recommendation to jump across into that specialty certification track and do the security special certification prior to any of the professional level ones. So if you do all the associate level certifications and then that security specialty one, you'll have a really, really strong foundation to be effective in almost any type of role working with AWS. You'll also be very well prepared to go a bit deeper in your study and take on those professional level certification exams. Now, at this point, some people may want to stay in the specialty track. You may want to pick a specialty certification that relates to your career field or career interests like machine learning or databases. Then these specialty certifications could be the end of your certification journey with AWS. If you're, you know, a data scientist or work in the machine learning space, you may not be expected to have other certifications or have the desire to really, you know, get deeper into solutions architecture or DevOps areas. So the professional level certifications today may be, you know, low value to you for your career and personal interests, But you can certainly learn and validate your skills with AWS Specialty Certifications that relate specifically for your field. So rather than stay within the Specialty Certifications after maybe you've done all the associate ones and then that security specialty, the next step is to continue with a more generalist approach and take that vertical leap into the professional track and tackle the Solutions Architect and DevOps Professional Certifications. Now, these Professional Certification exams are quite the leap in difficulty compared to the AWS level certifications. You'll need to be very well prepared and have that very broad and deep level of knowledge and skills to effectively answer the very lengthy and complex question scenarios that get thrown at you in those exams. Along with the technical difficulty of the exam questions, you're often racing against the clock in the professional level and specialty level exams as well, just due to how lengthy the questions and answer options are. You really have to budget your time well and go into the exam with a strategy that works for you. And again, this is why I recommend doing the Cloud Practitioner first, and then working up through the associate level certifications, and then taking what I feel is, you know, a bit more intermediate step with the security specialty, as, you know, it'll help you slowly build the AWS knowledge and skills to the point where you can tackle these difficult professional level exams. This approach also lets you get familiar with the AWS exam experience and the increased difficulty of the questions. You'll know what to expect and come up with strategies on how to answer the questions and, you know, really budget your time. So if you did take this vertical path and achieve one or both of the professional level certifications, at that point, then I'd say to look to the various specialty areas that are of interest or maybe related to a job role you have or would like to transition into. Now, the recommended paths I mentioned here are from my own experience taking and recertifying the exams over the years. Now, I've largely worn a solutions architect hat throughout my career, and I've been more interested in developing sort of that broader generalist knowledge and skills, and then slowly diving deeper and deeper into, you know, these different topic areas as time goes on. So again, if you're a database professional, you're looking to learn about AWS and see how different database technologies can migrate and operate on AWS, and, you know, the various managed database options on AWS, your certification path might, you know, look a lot different and focus on getting that database specialty certification. Now, for some additional help, AWS does offer a certification path guide outlining different certification progressions based on different role types and the expected responsibilities people have in these different roles. And while I think this is a great reference to supplement your overall certification path decisions, keep in mind these are general path recommendations based on the lens of, you know, someone already working in these types of roles already. They may not be the ideal progression path for someone starting out on their own, doing, you know, self-study with little on-the-job experience. If you're just starting out, you may benefit from a more incremental and broader certification path to expose you to more topics and help you build more experience along the way. So whatever your starting point is and your end goals are, these AWS certification path examples from AWS are just another resource for you to use to help determine where you should start and what path to take next. Well, that wraps up our tour here of the AWS certifications available today. And just remember, it's never too late to learn and grow. So use what you've learned today to choose the right certification track and certifications for you and your goals, and let your passion for AWS guide you to success. And if you're still unsure if AWS certifications are even worth doing at all for you, be sure to check out this video here and see you in the next one.